To demonstrate the use of the FileSystemWatcher class, I'm going to create a WPF application that shows you any new pictures the user adds to their picture folder. First, I'll go ahead and resize the window a little bit so that it is more of the shape of a normal picture, and I'll give the window a name. Let's call it main window. Next, I'm going to go into the toolbox here and drag over an image control. I just wanted to take up the entire main window, so I will just remove the margins. And let's call it updated image. So we want to create an event handler using the FileSystemWatcher class, which allows us to monitor a particular folder for changes. The FileSystemWatcher class is contained in the system.io namespace, so I'll add that now. First, I need to identify the user's pictures folder. I'll add it to a string called watched folder. And I will use the path.combine method to concatenate the user profile folder, which is an environment variable, and the pictures subfolder. So to get an environment variable, you can call environment.getEnvironmentVariable. And then I will specify the environment variable user profile. You can view all the environment variables at a command prompt by just running the command set. Now I'm going to combine the user's profile with the subfolder pictures, which in Vista is the default location for anybody's pictures. Now I just need to create a file system watcher instance for that path. I'll call it FSW, and I'll provide the path as part of the constructor. And to demonstrate how to interact with WPF controls, I will set the window's title to the path that we're monitoring. That way the user will be able to see that we're monitoring the correct folder. Now, FileSystemWatcher has a couple of properties that we might want to specify. Often if you're unloading pictures from a camera, it will load it into subfolders of the pictures folder. So I want to make sure we monitor subfolders as well. So I'll set the FileSystemWatcher.include subdirectories property to true. I also want to set the notify filter property so that updates are provided for a couple of different types of edits. You can see here I can have it notify me about changes to different aspects of a file. Attributes, of course, would be if a file attributes are edited. Creation time would change if somebody manually went in and edited the creation time, or if a new file were created with its own creation time attribute. Directory name would occur if a file was moved. File name would occur if a file was renamed. And then, of course, last access and last write would trigger the filter if a file was updated. If a file was appended or shortened, the size property would change. And of course, if a security descriptor were changed, the security filter would be used. For me, I'm going to trigger on file name and last write. That should be sufficient to let me know that that a new file was added. So now that I've configured the file system watcher, I'm going to create a handler for the changed event. You can see in C#, I specify it with the plus equals operator. It provides me with a default handler there. I just need to press tab to insert it, and it will type all this for me. Now, and again, it prompts me to press tab to generate the event handler. So I'm going to press tab now. And there I have an event handler. So now I need to write the event handler. I can remove the default exception there since I'm going to implement it now. Now, there's a trick I need to explain. I need to display the updated picture in this control. However, when you're handling events in a WPF application, the event handler is in a different thread, which means I don't have direct access to the controls in the window. So I could write this command. I could write updated image.source equals, and then specify the path of the updated file, but it won't actually work. I would get an exception because I wouldn't have access to the controls in the WPF window. So what I need to do instead is to use the dispatcher. So you can see I have direct access to updated image, and I will use the dispatcher.invoke command, which takes two parameters, a priority and then basically an action. I use the system.windows.threading.dispatcher priority constant to specify the priority of my dispatcher. Normal is fine. And then next I'm going to specify an action, literally by typing new action. So within this delegate, I'm going to specify the changes that I want to make. And first, I'm going to create an image source converter instance. This is just required to specify the source of the updated image control. You can't simply provide a source of a file path. So the image source converter converts from the file path to the source in the format that it's required. So now that I'm within the delegate, in the dispatcher, I can access updatedImage.source, cast it to ImageSource, and call the ImageSourceConverter.ConvertFromString method. So this is almost ready to go. I have one more change I have to make. I have to set the FileSystemWatcher.EnabledRaisingEvents to true. Otherwise, events simply won't fire. This is ready to run now. There's my picture window. I'll expand that a little bit. Now let me pull up my pictures folder. You can see here I have some vacation photos, so I will simply copy one of these photos to the same folder. And you can see that the WPF application detected the change, found the full path to the file, and displayed it in the image folder. I can do this repeated times with the same result. Now I want to demonstrate within the event handler how it found the folder path. Notice that the event handler, which was automatically generated by C#, takes two parameters. The sender object, which I don't access and I don't need to access typically, and the file system event args instance. Almost all event handlers have some derivative of event args. And the default code generated by Visual Studio always calls it E. So E has a variety of different useful parameters here, and they're specific to the event that's being thrown. So in this case, the File System Watcher event wants to let me know the file that was changed and what type of change happened to it. So you can see that it has three properties here. Change type, which is either changed or renamed. I could check that if I needed to. Full path, which is of course the full path to the file, and name, which is just the file name. So when I was specifying the path to the picture, I used the filesystemsEventArgs.fullPath property, sent it to the image source converter, and then cast that to image source.